Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am going to discuss about the Bloom's taxonomy in lectures. In our daily lectures, in our classroom lecturing, how to use the Bloom's taxonomy for the better learning of the student. That is what the objective of this lecture. I have 30 plus years of teaching experience in engineering colleges, and I have published 7 books in engineering, mechanical engineering, design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machines. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of the subjects for the benefit of the students, and the solution for the gate questions, solution and discussion for the gate questions are also I am uploading here for the students to pass in the gate examination, to use and pass in the gate examination. So before we get into the Bloom's taxonomy, let me begin with a quote from Swami Vivekananda. All the power is within you. You can do anything and everything. So this statement, this kind of the confident statement should come in the student's mind by our inspiring lectures. So when we inspire the student through lectures, definitely they will get all the power, they will realize their power within them. And another quote by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, the former President of India. The purpose of education is to make good human being with skill and experience. Enlightened human beings can be created by teachers. So the words are very, very much useful and realistic. So today our students, they require skill and experience, not just knowledge. They require the real skill, engineering skill, when they go to the job market or when they become an entrepreneur. So that kind of skill can be imparted by the teachers, and the enlightened human being can be created by the teachers. So this is the tribute to the Benjamin Bloom, who formulated, developed the taxonomy of learning skill somewhere in 1950 to 1970. So Benjamin Bloom, he lived between 1913 to 1999. So, PhD, he obtained PhD degree in education in 1942. So, worked in Chicago University, and he developed the taxonomy of learning skill during the year 1956 to 1970. According to him, his vision towards education must be increasingly concerned about the fullest development of all the children and youth. And it will be the responsibility of the schools to seek learning conditions which will enable each individual to reach the highest level of learning possible. So the school or the educational institution, they have to provide the basic infrastructure required and the basic amenities, teaching and learning environment required for the individual to reach the highest level of learning possible. That is what his vision for education. So Bloom's taxonomy. So university. So Benjamin Bloom in the University of Chicago in 1950 to 1970 sorted the learning objective of 3 domain based on the intellectual demand on the students. So what is the objective of learning? So the learning objective, they are divided into 3 domain. The first domain is cognitive domain. The cognitive domain deals with the person's ability to process and utilize information in the meaningful way. So, intellectual outcome including acquisition of knowledge, conceptual understanding and thinking and problem solving, they are all cognitive domain. So, in our regular teaching inside the classroom, either at the school level or the college level, we work only on the cognitive domain. So we help the student to acquire knowledge. So the cognitive domain is for knowledge, acquisition of knowledge. And affective domain, The affective domain deals with the attitude and feeling that results from or influence the learning process. So, what is the attitude? What is the feeling? What is the goal of the individual student to come to the college or the school for learning? The attitude or feeling that influences the learning process. Emotional outcome, including development of interest, attitude and value, that is what real driving force for the learning. And the psychomotor domain involves physical skill, psychomotor skill, skill outcomes including carry out laboratory and clinical procedure. Psychomotor domain, by doing physical work, by doing physical skill, right? So the student learn. So the learning domain, cognitive, affective and domain, affective and psychomotor domains, the three domains are important and equally developed for any youth. So for his betterment, for his better future. So in nutshell, the three domains of learning, cognitive domain, knowing things. So the head is involved, the organ is, head is involved, brain is involved, and all the sense organs are involved. Mental skill, that is knowledge. Psychomotor domain, doing it. So learning by doing. So through hands, a manual or physical skills. So skills are learned only by doing with the help of hands. Affective domain, so feeling and heart, emotions. The growth in feeling or emotional areas, that is what attitude. So the affective domain, the heart is involved, the feeling or emotions are developed here in the affective domain. So the various steps, various levels of cognitive domain, psychomotor domain and affective domain. So cognitive domain, remember, understand, apply, analyze, evaluate and create. And the psychomotor domain, reflex movements, basic fundamental movements, perpetual ability, physical abilities, skilled movement, non-discursive movements. And affective domain, receiving, responding, valuing, organizing and characterization. So here we are going to focus only the cognitive domain, because in our lecture we influence only the cognitive domain of the student or the youth. And look at the picture. So there are two domains involved in the picture. It is cognitive and affective. So there are more emotions on her face. So it is affective domain, and the knowledge is required to play the music instrument, that is cognitive domain. And this is again cognitive plus psychomotor. So the knowledge is required for the dance sequence, and the psychomotor skill is the dance. The activity is psychomotor domain, and the cognitive, the knowledge required for the movement, sequential movement of the dance. And this is dominant cognitive. So the students are learning, discussing, upgrading their knowledge. It is cognitive, dominant cognitive. And this is full of emotions. So this is dominant affective. And this is full of physical work and sport. This is dominant psychomotor. So in every activity, so all the three domains are involved. In every learning, all the three domains are involved. But sometimes some domain is dominating. But here in this lecture, so we are focusing only on the lecture in the classroom or teaching in the classroom, where the cognitive domain is predominant, and we discuss about the cognitive domain. So Bloom's taxonomy, which is revised in 2001 by Anderson. So initially it was developed by Bloom's in 1950s, and then later on it is revised by Anderson in 2001. The six levels are: remember, understand, apply, analyze, evaluate and create. So we'll see one by one. Remember, the meaning is recall facts or basic concepts. Understand, explain idea or concept. Apply, use information in new situation. Analyze, draw connection among ideas. And evaluate, justify a stand or decision. Create, produce new or original work. So the create is the highest level of the Bloom's taxonomy, cognitive level. So the student should be trained to reach the create, trained to reach the highest level from the basic. So without understanding, without realizing the importance of the basic domain, basic knowledge, basic information, basic cognitive level or the basic Bloom's level, it is very difficult to reach to the top. So the student should understand more, remember more, understand, and then apply whatever they understand. Then after application, they have to analyze, they have to compare. So once they compare, so they have to pick up the best answer or best thing. And for the best thing, they have to evaluate. Evaluation means giving justification for their decision. And then they will have to create a new or original work. These are all the different levels of learning. And here, the first three levels, they are called as lower level thinking skill. Lots. The top three level, they are called as higher order thinking skill or higher order cognitive skill, HOTS. So normally in our regular classroom, so we are working with the LOTS, lower order thinking skills, remember, understand and apply. But by creating an environment, ambience for learning, we can train the students on analyze, evaluate and create by designing and delivering our lecture effectively. And what is expected in each level? So we take one by one. So remember, so memorize and repeat the fact, replicate known procedure, recalling from the memory previously learned material, memory of previously learned material, that is what expected in the memory level, remember level. So they have to memorize the fact, certain information, certain definitions, certain rules, they have to remember. So all these things, they are coming under remember, whatever is required for future, whatever is required, whatever the formula required, so that they have to remember. Understand, so demonstrate the understanding of the concept and explaining the idea or concept. So the concept or idea is taught in the remember level, so they know it, but they have to demonstrate, paraphrase in their own words, they have to explain in their own words, that is what understanding. They have to demonstrate that they have understood the concept, so that is what understanding. Apply, so once they understand, they have certain equation, they can apply the knowledge in the new situation. So apply known procedure to a new situation on the problem and using the information in another familiar situation, that is what the application. So the first, they have to remember the basic things. Whatever is required, whatever is taught inside the classroom, they have to remember, then they have to understand and they have to apply. So the three levels are very important in our regular classroom teaching. So many of the students today, they are not able to reproduce the information in the examination because they are not remembering. So the information is not going to the permanent memory, long-term memory of the student. So in the classroom, by understanding the importance of the Bloom's taxonomy, by devising our lectures based on the Bloom's taxonomy, we have to give opportunity to the student to make them to take the information to their long-term memory, then only they can retrieve it and use it for the future. So the delivery and design of lecture will help the student to take the information, to take the lessons, so whatever we taught inside the classroom into their mind. Once they apply, then they do analysis. So they have different information based on the application, they have a lot of data generated. So they have to compare the data and you have to do the analysis. So solve complex problem, interpret data, figure out system behaviors and malfunctions. This is what the analysis. Breaking the information into part to explore the understanding and the relationship. That is what the analysis. Then evaluate. So after analysis, once you analyze the information or data, they can pick up the best information. They can pick up the best equipment. That is what evaluation. So the next level, evaluation. Once they make a decision, they have to support. They have to justify. So writing a justification, evaluation, that is what the evaluate. So make and support evidence-based judgment, justifying a decision or course of action. Then finally, create. So generating new idea products or new way of viewing the things. This is what the next level. So the analyze, evaluate and create, right? So by doing the first three effectively inside the classroom and giving the opportunity to the student for analyzing, evaluating and create, so in our regular course, so that will make the student to acquire all the six levels of learning. And further, so what the skill to be demonstrated by the student in every level, that we'll discuss. So in our regular classroom, we have to give opportunity, we have to understand that we teacher have to realize that the student remember the information. So for that, we have to give opportunity for them to demonstrate the skills. So in the level of remember, they should have the ability to recall the recall of information like facts, convention, definitions, jargons, technical terms, classification, categories and criteria. They need the ability to recall methodology and procedure, abstraction, principles and theories in the field, and know the dates, events and places, and mastery of the subject matter. So everything whatever we deliver inside the classroom, that they have to remember. So all these things we are delivering in our regular classroom, in the regular lecture from our lecture notes, so that they have to remember. And the skill, so in the understanding level, what is the skill to be demonstrated? So we have to give opportunity to the student, so to demonstrate the skills, understanding the information, grasping the information, translate knowledge into new context, interpret fact, compare and contrast, order, group and infer causes, predict consequences. So for all these things, they have to demonstrate that they are understanding the information. Then apply, use the information new situation. So for a problem solving situation, so they have equations, they have theory, they have to apply the theory and the equation for solving the problem. Use methods, concepts, laws, theories in the new situation. Solve problems using the required skill or knowledge, demonstrating correct usage of the method or procedure. That is what the application. And analyze the skills to be demonstrated. So break down a complex problem into parts. So this can be used in the project work. So the project work, they have to split up the chapter. They have to split up the entire project work. So first the material selection. Second, the design part. Third, the drawing part. Fourth, the fabrication part. Fifth, the assembly. Sixth, the testing. And then taking result and discussion. So these are all the levels. So the entire project, they have to split up into various levels. So this is the skill available in the analyze. So if they are doing it well, then that is they have very good analyzing skill. So identify the relationship and interaction between the different parts of the complex problem. Identify the missing information, sometimes the redundant information and the contradictory information, if any. So all these things they have to do in the analysis. And evaluate, compare and discriminate between ideas, assess the values of theories, presentations, make choices based on recent argument, verify value of evidence, recognize subjectivity, use of definite criteria for the judgment. So evaluation. So after the analysis, they have to evaluate which is the best. So for that, they have to use the knowledge. And finally, create. Use old idea to create new one. Combine parts to make a new or whole thing. And generalize from given fact. Relate knowledge from the several areas, predict and draw conclusions. That is what the create level, and these are all the skills to be demonstrated by the individual in the create level. And why Bloom Stacks Alarming Lectures? So as a teacher, we have to use Bloom's Taxonomy in the lectures. Why? Bloom's Taxonomy helps students to develop critical thinking, problem solving ability and higher order cognitive thinking of this. It influences the higher order thinking of the student. So the students, actually today they require these skill like critical thinking, problem solving ability, and require the higher order cognitive thinking for to be a successful engineer, to get the placement or to become an entrepreneur. So in our regular classroom, so we have to give opportunity for the student to learn the critical thinking, problem solving ability, and to achieve the higher order cognitive thinking. And why teachers use Bloom's taxonomy in the classroom? So why do we use the Bloom's taxonomy in the classroom? So to understand the student level and to develop them to higher cognitive level by the classroom activity. It helps the teacher to organize, classify the objective and the content of the lecture. So it helps the teacher to organize the level, which is coming under remember level, which is coming under understanding level, which is coming under application level, so analyze level. So orientation, so the lecture notes and your assessment, everything should be oriented towards the every level of Bloom's. And this is how we have to develop. So we have to develop the student from the remember level to the create level. Remember, understand, apply, analyze, evaluate, and then create. And these are all the action verbs available for use. You have to use during our lecture notes design and delivery of the lecture notes and in our assessment. So if it is remember type of questions or if it is remember type of topic, so we have to define, describe, duplicate, enumerate, examine, identify, label, list, locate, match, memorize, name, observe, omit, quote, like that. So all these words, they help to demonstrate our remembering level of thinking, remembering level of learning. And understanding, so demonstrate understanding of facts, idea by organizing, comparing, interpreting, giving description and starting main idea. Setting main idea, so ask, associate, cite, classify, compare, contrast, convert, like that. All the words can be used, action verbs can be used for understanding domain. And application, solve problems into new situation by applying the acquired knowledge, fact, techniques and rules in different way. So for example, act, administer, apply, collect, complete, compute, construct, determine, discover, dramatize, establish, employ, examine. So all these verbs can be used for application domain or apply domain. And analyze, so examine and break information into parts by identifying motives and causes. So make inferences and find evidences to support generalization. Advertise, analyze, appraise, calculate, categorize, classify, compare. So these are all the action verbs can be used for analyzing depending on your subject and the content of the topic. Evaluate, so present and defend opinions by making judgment about the information, validity of ideas or quality of work based on the set of criteria. So appraise, argue, assess, choose, compare. So compare, some of the words are repeatedly used in all the domain. So actually in each domain we have to use it with the proper phrases of the question. And create, so compile information together in a different way by combining element in a new pattern or proposing a new solution. So adapt, anticipate, assemble, etc. These are all the words used for creating domain. So in nutshell, so we understand the objective of Bloom's taxonomy, teach the students about the Bloom's taxonomy. So in the first class, normally when you enter into the first class, you discuss the Bloom's taxonomy with the student and the importance of the six cognitive levels of learning with the students. So use Bloom's taxonomy now in designing your lecture, practice Bloom's taxonomy in delivery of the lecture and apply Bloom's taxonomy in the assessment of students' performance. And to help the students to acquire higher order thinking skill. So through our lectures. So I conclude with the words from William James of Harvard University. Both the statements are from him. The greatest discovery of my generation is that human being can alter their lives by altering their attitude of mind. So we change our attitude and help the student for betterment. When a person excels in the profession, 85% of the time it is because of their attitude, only 15% of the time because of how smart they are and how many facts and figures they know. So we change our attitude for betterment of the future engineers. So thank you for listening. If you like your like the video, you share with your friends and subscribe the channel. Thank you.